Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode Hub channel. I am Frederick and I'm happy to have you here today. In this video, we are going to look at how to display the progress of a file when uploading in .NET 8 Blazor application. This cuts across in all the render modes, talking about the Blazor, Interactive Server, Interactive WebAssembly, and the Auto. Before we jump right into this, make sure you have subscribed to this channel and also hit on the notification bell, so you never miss out any of our upcoming content. I do also offer coaching to people who are interested in Blazor or even .NET technologies, talking about the Blazor, MAUI and our MAUI Blazor Hybrid and Web API services. So check the video description and I have an email that you can write to me through it. You know, file upload is very essential in our Blazor applications because it enables us to upload file into application. Now in this, we want to actually display the progress of the file whilst the file is being uploaded. Let's have a look on how to do that. So we're going to create a .NET 8 web app. So Blazor web app, and this is going to be demo upload with progress. So that's the file name. And maybe I'll put this to GitHub so we can just go in there for this. So demo upload file with progress. Okay, so in Blazor. Okay, now click on next. .NET 8 framework and the interactive mode here. We're going to use server, but you can choose interactive WebAssembly. You can choose the auto. Anyone's going to work. So let's get this project created. So yeah, instead of you sitting down to write a whole lot of bunch of code to make this work, we have specified this, or we've created this into a package as a .NET, as a NetcodeHub package. So we're going to install this package, and this package, actually the core of it here is to display the progress of a file when uploading. And now in this, I recommend or I can acknowledge Gerard for his framework and support for this, okay, because based on the framework we're able to create or design this. All right, so let's see how to work with it. What we need to do now is to install the package, and it's a very simple step. After installing the package, what we're going to do here is we are going to import the namespace, then we can use this component. Three steps and we are done. Let's have a look. So we're going to install this package in here. We go to solution, right click on dependencies. Let's go to manage Nugget packages. Now in here, let's go to the browse tab and I'll type in, let's see, netcode. So just netcode, we're going to pop up all the three packages that I have published, and we need netcode hub. So we need a third one, and that is this NetcodeHub.Packages.Components.FileUpload. So with this, we're going to install this package. As you know, this package allows you to upload multiple files with progress bar display in your Blazor application. So let's install this package. Okay, so once this is done, this is the first step to do. We're going to close this because we are done. The next thing that we're going to do here is we go to our components. So let's say we have the pages, and in that we have this home page. Okay, so now with this home page, what we need to do here is include the namespace. So using then netcode. So we need netcode hub.packages. So dot component dot file upload. So that is the namespace this package is coming from. Component dot file upload. Then the component folder here is file upload with progress. So that's the namespace that you need to add. Now, when you're done adding the namespace, what you need to do next here is to include or use this component. So the component here, it is upload. So as you can see from this one, file upload is what we need to use. So we can just, because we've added this already. So after adding this component, we need to set this as interactive auto. So let's say we have this interactive, that is on the server, because it is a server project that we created. So you must make sure interactive server. Send this file upload is going to be a button, which is going to be an interactive. We have to enable the render mode. Okay. All right. So now we have this. Let's run this application and now check it out. So the app is ready. Now let's see. So I'm going to click on this to choose files. So I have these files in here. This is a zip file and I have these three images. I'm going to select all because, you know, this supports multiple files. Click on open and now check it out. So you can see that we have the progress bar. If I zoom it well, you can see we have the progress bar in here and it is loading. From this up to this, the total size here, and that is the stage of the being loaded, right? So we have it, and now this looks good, isn't it? But the issue is, how do we access this files? Because you know, when you check the source, we just added the component and now we are having this. So where can we retrieve or where can we get the file that we selected? All these files, where can we get them? Let's see how to retrieve the files in there. So the first thing that we have to do here is, let's create our code section. So in our code section, we want to create this iBrowser file as an iList, because you know this is a list of files, so we want to gather them as a list, and we have to create a container to handle that. No, this is not interactive server. I don't want to paste this one. That is this. So we need to create an iList browser file, and now we store it as file. We initialize it to what, new, control KD. Okay, now in that, this has some parameter that we can provide or we can have access to. We have this first, we can have access to the reference attribute. So let's see, reference attribute, and now we can say that this file here, we're going to create an instance that is a file upload component. Okay, now whilst you have this, we have the container created. We're going to hold all the files that have been selected within this component. Okay. Now, in order to do this, we have to attach a method to this, and that is notify. So we want to notify this page as soon as this event or a file upload event occurs. So we can call this method in here as a parameter. And as you can check this, it is coming in with a list of iBrowser files. So it's a read only, meaning we can read it only. Now we need to create a method for this retrieve content, so we can retrieve the content from this component. All right, so let's see. And now this method, we need to pass in the listings. It is coming in with this I read only list. We have to pass in as a payload so we can retrieve it in here. So we are checking. Now this is what it does. You know, it could be that the user can select a wrong file, or maybe a file which has dot 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 as a name. In such case, we want to rectify, we want to address or alert the user that the file that been selected is not what we want, okay? Because the file name must have only dot in it for the extension. If we have netcode.project. As a file name, this file upload component is going to accept that. Yes, so we want to first check. So this is what it does. Anytime that it uses a file, it gets notified to this parent. And now with this retrieve method, a retrieve content, a method here, it does called. And now when it is called, it's going to pass in a null for the first time when it is checking up for any results or any errors and unclear the content. It's passing in what it passes, null check. The next time after these files have been retrieved, scrutinized and also added to the file list, then it's going to invoke this again. So this method is going to call twice. The first one to check for errors, the second one is to return the actual content. Okay, so in that, we have to check If the content here, if it is null, it means it is checking for error, then we can hide this. So let's see this, what we are doing. Let's wait for this command to finish. I hate this. Okay, so we are saying that if this content or incoming file is not null, that is only when we want to do this. So the incoming file that is coming from this file as upload component, we are looping through it and adding it to the file. That's a list of files that we have created or stored in here as a container. So when you're done with this, it means you have all your files in here and now you can perform all your tasks. If you want to save to database, you want to do anything else to it, you can actually do it together, because here you're having the file being stored here. Okay, in case it is not, then it's going to return. And to retrieve the errors, what can we do? We first have to create a property for this error as string. So let's say this is a string error. Now in here we are going to say error.fileupload. There's an inbuilt method known as get errors, so we can get error, any error that occurred during the file upload, we're going to retrieve it in here now display. So example, let's write it and see. We are going to include a div. So let's include div class, and now this class is going to have an alert and alert danger. And now in here let's have this errors here. Okay, let's run this up and now check it out. So we're going to run this again. So we have the div alert here. Now we're going to choose a file, and now this file that we're going to choose, we're going to, let's edit this. So this is, I think it is png file. It has the extension of png, but we're going to add one dot here. So data dot bi dot, whereby this is going to make an error. Okay, as soon as you select this. So let's see, if I choose these three files here and I click on open, let's see what happened. It tells you that the multiple dots in file is not accepted. Please make what changes and I'll try again. So the three files have been selected, but it was not able to upload because of what we had an error in one. And now when you have error in one, the other two are not going to be uploaded unless you fix it. Okay, so here we can have access to the content. That's why we do not have any display down here. Let's choose this one and let's use this one. Click on open, and now you can see that we have the files being listed in here with the various files. And now with this, you can now start to do whatever thing that you want to do to it. Now in that, let's also debug this and check it out and see what I'm talking about as well. Let's put a breakpoint here. Now we want to check if we have the actual files here, right? Now let's see. So in the component, we're going to refresh this. Let's use this files again. So open. Okay. So now this is loading. And now let's wait and see where we're going to have the breakpoint. Now this is loading. So we wait for this to finish loading. Now you see that as soon as this is done, almost done, we have the breakpoint hit. Now if I hover the mouse here, it tells you the number of files that we have. So currently what is coming here, it is three files, right? That's what we selected. Now these three files are going to be added to this file. So currently the file here, it is three, you see. Now let's click on continue. We have three files in here. We are going to add another one. So let's add the same file, click on open, and now the breakpoint is hit. Let's check. So here we must have four. You see now it is four. But when you check this, it is only one, because that's the incoming file. You can see that is the name and that is the size. That's an ID. So you can see that is a way to use this file upload. Very simple one. All that you need to do is install the package, use the namespace, use the component. And now if you want to retrieve the files in here, use this 10 lines of code and now boom, you're done. I believe that is simple. Yes. So that's a way to integrate it. So keep using this. Now try to use this component or this package anytime that you want to have a nice GUI for a file upload by including progress display as well. Okay, so thank you. And I'm going to catch up in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself.